You know, this was an interesting process for me because a lot of the cast had done the show before in San Diego, and I was a new addition to the cast for this production. So when we came in the first day, before we started, I said, please send me all the music, send me the script so that I can kind of catch up with everybody, just in thinking about the role and thinking about the process. So that when we came together on the first day, you know, we all had ideas, the director had ideas, the other cast had ideas of what these characters should be and how they should relate, and then we all kind of had to like meet in the middle through rehearsal. So that was exciting to hear what other people thought of the character, to talk to the director about what I felt like his arc should be. So it was a very exciting build process.
Well, we've been working on this for a few years now. So we did another production out in California. It started at the Old Globe Theater in San Diego. So this is the second production that this musical has gotten here in New Jersey. So I was able to do the first one and now the second one. It's great to have a longer space of time to work on a character, especially of June, who is a functioning schizophrenic. And they name it in the show. They're very specific about naming it. So when I was going about creating a character who has schizophrenia, I wanted to be thoughtful about how we were presenting her, because in the media you see so many representations of mental illness, particularly schizophrenia, that are extreme. You see, you know, serial killers or geniuses, and June is just a normal girl who wants normal things. And we wanted to do that justice.
The film is wonderful, so it was a lot to live up to, but it was also a great source of material and guidance. The film, they make beautiful usage of really emotional moments that involve a lot of close-ups, which is hard to do on stage because you just have one view. So the challenge was figuring out how to fulfill the emotion that those close-ups are giving you in the film and translating them to a stage. And in some ways that was also the most rewarding, because for a musical, a lot of musicals are not written around just kind of everyday people, small stories with big emotional landscapes, but these are just working everyday people. There's only 8 of them in the show. It was rewarding to get a chance to tell that story. What I take away from it is watching two very human people finally deal with a tragic loss and the grief that came with when their parents passed away. So to me, the story is very funny and charming, but in the end, you're watching a brother and a sister finally move through their grief into something beyond that.
I always wanted to do this part, and when I found they were making it into a musical, I wrote to the producer and I said, I really want to play the Johnny Depp role, and I have some ideas, you know. So, and then early in rehearsal, Kirsten Gunther, the book writer, and I were talking about how could we make him different from the movie, and we had this idea of movie quotes. You know, he's obsessed with movie quotes, and it gave us the chance to hear from many different, you know, old-time movies, to hear from Jimmy Stewart, to hear from Cary Grant. You know, Sam, the character, uses these characters' words in place of his own, which he has trouble finding. And once we found that game, we just found that we love to play it throughout the show. So I don't actually know how many I do in the show, but there's got to be 15 or 20 quotes in there. Sam is such a vessel for play. He sees the world differently. He's always looking for a way to make people laugh. You know, he's trying to help people with laughter, and that's one of the reasons I love performing. I love hearing people laugh from something that myself and my castmates have done, and luckily we heard a lot of that tonight, so...